And Chris, your safety is number one here. Don't get too close to this. We see a lot of people there in front of you trying to get up on this storm, but this is a dangerous place to be.
This is about to be bad.
Tornadoes are some of the most powerful displays of Mother Nature's wrath. Seeing video of a tornado, for most, used to seem like something out of the Wizard of Oz. But in today's age of cell phones, we see tornado videos all the time. It's not that more tornadoes are happening, it's just we have more people in the path capturing the moments. It was a movie half a century after The Wizard of Oz that inspired a surge of storm chasers.
Research is deadly. The laboratory is nature itself.
Twister put storm chasing on the map, mixing weather enthusiasts with scientists all trying to get up close to a tornado. In fact, the phrase Twister effect was coined after the movie's release, citing a 47% increase in bachelor degrees in meteorology from 1994 to 2004. Many credit this guy for the inspiration behind the movie.
Like flies. Storm chasers started converging from a little one-lane country road we were on, dropping everything.
In order to improve warnings of tornadoes, we need to understand why tornadoes form. We have a relatively vague idea of why tornadoes form. We don't know exactly why. We can identify the types of storms that produce tornadoes, but as you saw today, a lot of them simply don't produce tornadoes. Why do some produce tornadoes and others don't? We've been trying to answer this question for many years.
On this day, there were many more people on the road than just Howie. Scientists, amateur chasers, and others who were making a buck by filling vans with people who want the adrenaline rush of seeing a tornado. It's called chaser tourism.
I started the tours originally just to pay for my own chasing. I was going to take one or two people along with me. In 1997, a company out of Germany decided, they wanted to book 16 people. You know, it was a sweepstakes trying to promoting the release of Twister. And I thought, I can do that. And since then, tour business has become more of a big business.
A better vantage point.
Well, certainly storm chasing has become a more popular sport over the years. And with the advent of technology where you can just on your phone see where storms are at, it brings a certain element of people out there that just want to go ahead and see what the storms are firsthand.
Can we back up?
But over the years, a dangerous phenomenon called chaser convergence has emerged. When hundreds of people are all chasing the same storms, roads can get blocked, some people drive recklessly, and lives are at risk, just for the thrill of the chase.
Oh, it's grown explosively. Unfortunately, the other day when we were out chasing, yesterday, for example, we had trouble finding a parking spot because there were so many chasers. And then we would stop and set up the radar and start to collect data. And all of a sudden, like a magnet, people started coming from all directions. They would stop and sometimes block the road and make it difficult for us.
All right, I'm John Marr, my wife Mary Marr. I've got an excavating business. We're just out chasing storms. Well, we go three or four times a year. We just always enjoyed the storms, just going out around the house and seeing what's happening, and it's just kind of growed from there.
John and Mary say when they see the scientists on the road chasing storms, they try to stay out of the way, but it's also a sign they're on the right track.
So you can't go far wrong when you're falling behind all those types of guys.
Well, it's not frequently that it presents as problems, but I will say this. The increase of people on the highways is getting more and more dangerous because they're clogging up the roads, they're going slow, and then we have roadblocks that are being put up, and that's just ending up to be a lot more traffic.
Oh, there wow. He goes.
This
is about to be an accident. I don't like this.
The El Reno tornado in 2013, we were in a traffic jam on Interstate 40 in Oklahoma, and the storm was coming towards us, and we were collecting data, but we had to leave. We had a lot of difficulty getting out. Had the tornado actually come right towards us, we would have been in trouble.
we're gonna have to back up quick, dude.
Oh my God, it's pulling up.
In fact, the El Reno tornado was deadly for three veteran storm chasers. They were out studying tornadoes to help develop better lead times for tornado warnings. The storm turned on a dime, putting them in its path, proving how dangerous storm chasing can be for even the most seasoned veterans. Then in 2017, three more chasers were killed when their cars collided. But if you ask any meteorologist, most would agree that storm chasers are an essential part of developing better weather technology, in turn keeping the public safe when a tornado strikes. Learning more about the anatomy of the storms will help forecasting them. Better forecasts will lead to better warnings and more lives saved.
Hopefully one can take the observations that we make with the mobile radars, which are very, very high resolution. On the other end, you take the computer models, try to mesh them together, and when you do that, we're hoping to come up with a better understanding. If we can come up with a better understanding, we can give better warnings.
Howie will continue to chase and research severe storms to help the cause, but when you ask him about starting this whole revolution of meteorologists and storm chasers, he doesn't take the credit.
So it's nice to inspire. You can ask my students. Maybe I don't know if I've inspired them at all. I hope I have. But basically, I don't really think about that. I like what I do. I've always liked what I do.
Yes. Everything is serious. Nothing I can do about it.